Hey buddy, Brick Barron's back, and I have a quick video here about the Women of NASA set that LEGO just decided to approve. Got 10,000 supporters, and they this is it. We're gonna go with this set here, even though it kind of isn't in the LEGO Ideas guidelines. The guidelines state you shouldn't have minifigures primarily as a set idea, but clearly they're going with this one, which unfortunately means this is not going to be made. LEGO Ideas is supposed to be a great place for builders out there to showcase their work to potentially be made into a LEGO set. I would love the opportunity to build that, mainly because of all the trees and the foliage. You don't get a lot of that in LEGO sets. Don't get that one. And this one I also had high hopes for. I was really hoping for this one as well. Again, you get a lot of foliage, a lot of the greenery in there. And I know Western isn't has been a theme that hasn't done really well for Lego, but I do feel as a one-shot set, this one being historically tied with a very positive female role model, Laura Ingalls Wilder, I mind you, I thought it had a lot of potential, but again, it wasn't made. And of course, we have the Lego's Addams Family Mansion, which was not made either. Now, this one I kind of get because it had like I think 10,000 pieces in it. It was really detailed. And Lego does have the Scooby-Doo stuff out now, still on the shelves, and they just finished Monster Fighters, like, 2, 3 years ago. So I can maybe see why they might have passed on the set, but I'm sorry, man, but those are the kind of sets that builders want. We want that. A minifig set, primarily with minifigures in it, is not something that gets me really excited. It's not to say that the women of NASA don't deserve their to be characterized in Lego. I think there's just better ways to do it than with an idea set. But so I was kind of thinking, well, why would Lego pick that? And I think really when I kind of go back through it, it's kind of simple, really. There's a big stigma with Lego. Lego gets a bad rap in the media, had been for years. The media has created this ridiculous storyline, this narrative they kind of run over and over again that Lego doesn't care about girls. And it kind of started back in 2014. I'm sorry, yeah, 2014, when this little nice little girl Charlotte wrote this letter to Lego, hey, I would like to have some girl sets. Why don't you consider us and all that stuff? And little Charlotte's, I'm sure, a great little girl, and like it's awesome she wrote this letter. And unfortunately, Charlotte probably had the most pure intentions, but of course, once the media gets a hold of it, well, it turns into the typical old, oh, see, Lego, oh, they don't care about girls, yada yada yada, which is totally ridiculous, but that's what they always say, and they take Charlotte's letter, which was probably well meaning and well thought out, and they kind of twist it all around, making her into like an Oliver Twist, right? So, but here's the thing, and the media needs to understand this because clearly they don't get it. Lego has always cared about girls. They've always done the best they could to market to them. This is an ad from 1981. Now, back in the late 70s and early 80s, Lego, when they had the minifigures first introduced, you have to understand Lego, the minifigures themselves weren't really gender specific. They were sort of unisex. And a lot of this, the sets and the color palettes in those sets and the bricks were very gender neutral. In other words, girls and boys both play with them and built whatever they wanted. Boys might have been building a, I don't know, a ship, and girls might have been building a house. I don't know. But the point is, they all played with them at some point. And anyway, so after Charlotte's letter comes out and the media runs all their stories about Lego, so of course they put this set out right afterwards. Coincidence? I don't think so. I think it was something they did to kind of, take the media pressure off them for a little bit. I understand it. No company wants negative pressure. I get that. And this is a nice set. Don't get me wrong. I really do like it, and I think it definitely is something Lego could have made, and I'm fine with that. I really am. But this old storyline, Lego doesn't care about girls, is absolutely ridiculous, and it's just it needs to stop. Let's go through memory lane for a second here. So from 89 to 2003, Lego made many attempts to market sets to girls. They started to get a little more specific with that, and as you know, this is the time frame when Lego was trying to broaden out, I guess, their appeal to all kinds of markets. So there was Paradisia, which was, these were nice sets too. I love the colors in these. There was Belleville. There was Scala. There was even Clickets. Now, the point is, from 89 to 2002, Lego made an effort. Now, you could argue that the sets they were producing designed with girls in mind, maybe the sets weren't that well designed. Maybe they could have been better. Maybe they didn't have appeal to girls. You know, I get all that. Those are factors you can certainly look at. But the bottom line is, whatever the reason, you know, the sets didn't sell well. And just by, you can't produce something in your company that's not selling. You're going to lose money. And, you know, honestly, you know, it doesn't take a genius to figure out that if you keep doing that, you know, over the years, well, you get into a lot of trouble. And the sets, and it really, Lego was on the verge of bankruptcy, as you guys all well know. Again, a coincidence that from 89 and 2001, 2002, they were trying to produce all those sets, but they weren't selling. Therefore, everything starts to, their bottom line falls way down. Well, in 2004, they had to do something. So they went back to base, look, what sells? And this is what sells. It is, I'm sorry. Or at least it has been historically for them. Now, this pie chart shows you is the minifigures that were included in sets in all their different themes, castle, city, space, all things they were doing. As you can see, there was still, the bulk of them were still general neutral unisex, but you see there were more boy minifigures in these sets as opposed to girls. That's kind of what it's showing you in this pie chart, because that's what was selling. You know, it's just business. I'm sorry. It doesn't mean that Lego doesn't care about girls. It's just about staying afloat. And curiously, after they started doing this, within a few years, by 2007, they're solvent again. And they're making money. And there are other things that came, there are other things that contributed. Yes, I know that. So don't fill the comments up with all those things. But the bottom line is, that was one of the major things Lego did to get themselves back on track again. So let's go back to Women of NASA now. Now, I want to be clear about my take on this. I'm not knocking the set. I think it's a great idea. And I like it, because women have been marginalized throughout history, and it's not fair. But I do think that Lego could have done this instead with this idea. They could have gone with a minifigure collectible series. Maybe do like the next series coming up, do a Women of Science. I mean, pick like 18 women of science from history, or maybe broaden it a bit and say women famous or important women of society, science, history. Weave them all in. You could have like Joan of Arc. I mean, you could have a whole bunch of them. So that's, I think they should have gone with that instead. But again, I'm not knocking the set. I like the idea of honoring the women, but not with a Lego idea set. My point is, I think it's better serviced as a minifigure series. So I don't know. But see, getting back to what I was saying before, you know, I am just an average builder. I am. I'll be honest with you. I'm not a spectacular builder. You've seen my mocks. They're okay. They're not like spectacular. They're not like 10,000 supporter kind of spectacular. So for me, I like getting those idea sets to see what other people are building. And I can get all the pieces in the kit at one shot and build it myself, have fun with it, display it, whatever, modify it as I see fit. Because I can't do that myself. I'm just not that skilled. And to buy all the parts through different sellers on BrickLink and eBay everywhere, I mean, the cost would be like three times as much as buying the kit from Lego. So that's kind of where I'm going with this thing, man. Again, so I don't want to be clear. I want to be clear that the Women of NASA set is certainly an important idea. It certainly deserves its place. But I think that Lego would be better serviced making that into a collectible minifigure line as opposed to a Lego idea set. So, that is my rant, folks. Thanks for listening. As always, you know, I'll see you later. Bye.